वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल जियोलॉजिका। दिस इज द जियो केमिस्ट्री एंड वी विल सी अबाउट द आयनिक सब्सटीट्यूशन एंड मोर स्पेसिफिकली गोल्डस्मिथ्स रूल एंड द रिंगवुड्स मॉडिफिकेशन फॉर दैट रूल्स। एंड वी विल सी नॉट ओनली द रूल्स बट ऑल्सो हाउ वी कैन अप्लाई दीज रूल्स इन द वेरियस जियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस। सो लेट्स बिगिन। आयनिक सब्सटीट्यूशन रिप्लेसमेंट और रिप्लेसिबिलिटी ऑफ वन और मोर काइंड्स ऑफ आयन इन अ क्रिस्टल लैटिस बाय अनदर काइंड्स ऑफ आयन। सो वी हैव डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ आयन्स इन एनी क्रिस्टल एंड दीज आयन्स कैन बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय ईच अदर एंड दिस रिप्लेसमेंट इज नोन एज द आयनिक सब्सटीट्यूशन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल वी हैव टू एंड मेम्बर्स ऑफ ओलिविन फैमिली दैट आर फॉस्फोराइट एंड फायलाइट एंड आउट ऑफ दोज the chemical formula is same except that phosphorite had magnesium and phyllite have iron. So these iron and magnesium can be replaced by each other due to the ionic substitution. So this substitution is controlled by many factors and the Goldsmith proposed some rules for this ionic substitution. So now let us see the Goldsmith's rules of ionic substitution. First rule states that the ions of one element can replace those of another in ionic crystal if radius differs by less than 15%. Now let us assume that we have two ions like those of magnesium and iron belongs to the olefin family phosphorite and phyllite. If these two ions have difference in their radius less than 15%, then they can replace each other. If the difference in radius is more than 15%, they will not replace each other. Okay, so this is the rule. And by except the extent of this substitution, how much substitution can takes place, it depends on the concentration of ions. If there is more iron, then definitely it will lead to the more substitution. On the temperature, it also depends on the temperature. As the iron is more susceptible while temperature is high, it will lead to the more substitution. For example, we have a mineral is sphalerite, that is zinc sulfide ZnS. The concentration of iron Fe plus 2 in sphalerite increases with the temperature. Okay, provided that enough iron was available to saturate the sphalerite. If there is much higher temperature, then more will be the substitution. Okay, so this is the amplification of Goldsmith rule. First rule that we can calculate the temperature at which crystal is formed by that the amount of substitution. Now the second rule is ions whose charge differ by one unit. Now there we have same charges. Now if we have the different charges, one has plus one and another has the plus two charges, then what will happen? They substitute readily for one another, provide electrical neutrality of the crystal is maintained. Now if we replace a one positive ion by the two positive ions, then definitely there will be and the stability will decrease because of ions are not crystal is not neutral. If the charges of the ions differ by more than one, if the difference is more than one, such as we have one ion with one positive charge, another ion with 3, 4, 5 positive charges, then substitution is generally slight or there is no substitution. Now how this can be used? If charge is different, okay, one such as we have sodium, okay, Na, it has one charge, then we have calcium which has two charge, okay. Now if we replace sodium by calcium, calcium is taking place in place of sodium, so what will happen? There will be one extra positive charge, and for this one extra positive charge we have to remove some positive charge. Okay, for that removal there will be another substitution form. Okay, so this is the definition: charge deficiency that result from substitution of ions of unequal charges must be compensated by a second substitution. Okay, there will be second substitution involving an ion having different charge. This process is known as coupled substitution. Okay, you can see this in the feldspars, plagioclase feldspars, where you have albite and anorthite. In the albite we have Na plus, and in the anorthite we have calcium 2 plus. So when calcium is replacing the sodium, definitely there will be one extra positive charge, and this extra positive charge will be compensated by the addition of one aluminium ion in place of silica. Okay, so it's the Goldsmith's second rule, and we can apply in the Plagioclase feldspar. Now the third rule is, when two different ions can occupy a particular position in a crystal, when there are two ions and they can occupy the single position, okay, then what will happen? The ion with higher ionic potential, as I have told in my previous video about the ionic potential, okay, so the ion with higher ionic potential forms a stronger bond than the anion surrounding the site. Okay, so listen, this is the Goldsmith's third rule. Now consequently, ions with higher ionic potential are concentrated in early form crystals, because they can substitute easily, so they will form in early form crystals in the cooling magma, where the ions which have lower ionic potential will definitely substitute after the substitution by the higher ionic potentials. So the lower ionic potential element will definitely found in the residual melt or the late forming crystals. So we can apply the third rule in this way. Now the Ringwood's modification. As you know that every rule has some sort of exceptions. So this exception is defined by the Ringwood's modification. He said that even when the size and charge criteria are satisfied, when the competing ions have different electronegativity, they form bonds of different ionic characters. Okay, you have same charges, you have same radius as well, but it also depends on the electronegativity. Okay, we have example. This is the example. Sodium and copper both have one positive charge and both have the ionic radius almost similar. Okay, same charge, ionic radius are virtually identical but do not substitute each other. The reason is that copper forms more covalent bond than sodium. Okay, because of electronegativity. So we have albite, we have halite, and in these two minerals the copper is not substitute the sodium ions. Okay, we are not able to find till now any halite composing of CuCl or albite having CuAlCl3O8. So this is the Ringwood's modification, that they also depends on the electronegativity and their ionic characters. Okay, it is not always true that element have higher ionic potential will definitely substitute another mineral. Okay, so they will also depend on the electronegativity, but this is very less occurring phenomena. Okay, so it's now going to be end. When the two mineral ions have similar ionic potential, the one whose electronegativity is more similar to that of major ion, the ion to which we are going to substitute, if the electronegativity is almost similar, it will lead to a substitution. If electronegativity is vary, or we have the difference in electronegativity, it will not substitute the element. Okay, it's all about for today. In another video we will see different type of ionic substitution, like Kamel flake, capture, admittance, and how they can amplify in the other way. Okay, thank you so much.